Imagine you are an officer working in a volcano observatory and your job is monitoring the volcano's activity. One day, the monitoring instrument in your office records increasing trend of variables. You have to decide whether you press the red button, meaning you declare that the volcano is going to erupt, or you wait until the very last minute, but risking the safety of the people living nearby the volcano. The situation is similar to the situation in stock market when traders have to decide whether they buy or they sell stocks based on the trend they are observing. Forecasting the onset of volcanic eruption is never easy. Attempts to forecast the eruption time have been initiated by a volcanologist named Barry Voigt in 1988 when he introduced a method called failure forecast method, or FFM. The FFM equation has exponential or power law form, depending on the trend of the data, and by fitting our data to the FFM equation, we can forecast the onset of the eruption. This FFM method has been used to forecast eruption time in several events, but some are not successful. Here I want to improve the forecast accuracy by choosing migrating seismicity as the data that will be plugged into the equation. The rationale behind this choice is that to have an eruption, there is a necessity for magma to migrate to the Earth's surface. And every time magma is migrating, it will trigger earthquakes. Therefore, we will also see an upward migrating seismicity. The signals recorded during the migration phase show exponential or power law trend, hence gives us the temptation of fitting the signals to FFM equation. As an example, I'll give you two contrasting phases happened before the eruption of Pitong de la Fornés volcano in January 2010. Both phases show increasing trend of seismicity, but one is without migrating seismicity and the other has migrating seismicity. Both phases meet the requirement to be fitted to the FFM equation. But as you can see in the graph, fitting the data of the first phase gives us wrong forecast on eruption time, while fitting the data of the second phase gives us better forecast on eruption time. So my point is that despite using the same variable, which is seismicity, the migrating seismicity phase gives better forecast on eruption time. This finding can help volcano observatories deciding when to press the red button, minimizing casualties and economic loss. Thank you.